trying to get the inside of the reach of Colbey. Says she's got the power to knock Colbey out tonight. Colbey broke with the jab, the high kick early. Takes her up. Richard Pugney is going. Chance of right hand. There's another one from Colbey Northcutt. Here comes Northcutt. A house on fire. And Richard Pugney gets inside the phone booth and ties her up. Looking for a takedown, Richard Pugney. Colbey Northcutt wants to stop her around. Have a look at this. And Richard Pugney pushes up.
She can't allow the long legs of Northcutt to start to get extended. She's got to try to stack her. She's got to try to stack her and then pull that arm out. Get that arm away from the joint manipulation right there that she's doing. Now you can see Colby's transferring to a triangle. She's trying to. Tommy's doing a good job of kind of shutting that down and keeping her arms nice and tight to the body of Northcutt. She goes back to the arm bar, though.
And she survived another attempt at the arm bar. Gets an intestinal fortitude, but is it enough? She looks relaxed. Belly down on by now. Colbey Northcutt, no. And Putrid Pugney survives again.
I think Pugney's got some incredibly flexible arms right there. So Northcutt might have to choke her if she wants to finish this on the ground. Now she's getting deep into the triangle. This is what she wanted. Those long legs give her a very good advantage in snatching up some triangles. And now she's got to try to adjust right now. Now she's got to try to turn her body and put her head kind of to the other side. That's it. She's got to adjust.
Poochie Pugney, tremendous strength, tremendous resilience. But how long can she survive with Colbey Northcutt throwing up submission after submission? Poochie Pugney would like to break this open and bring down the cradling power. There's some hellish strength for the Indonesian.
Pugney is incredibly tough. She's doing a good job of defending. See how high her shoulder is to her chin? That's going to give her a little bit of space to breathe. Now, if Northcutt chooses to go under the leg, I think she is. I think she's under the leg. Now she might be able to create a little bit more torque onto that choke. Pugney's got to keep her stacked. She can't allow her to extend. Can't allow this choke to get tighter and tighter. There might be some elbows possibly right here for Pugney.
What a debut so far from Colbey Northcutt, the 36-time karate world champion. A nice thing to the side of the head there from Putra Pugney.
That's what Pugney needs to start doing. She's got to utilize this opportunity to deliver some ground and pound. She can't allow these minor little adjustments from Northcutt. She's got to start ground and pounding, deliver some knees, deliver some hands. Create some separation here, but this is a little bit awkward of a position. You can see just how tight the triangle choke is, but I think Pugney might have enough room to breathe.
There's a little peppering punches off the right angle from Putri Pugney, trying to get Colbey Northcutt to break this hold as Colbey hands out the submission. Foul down bars. Now the triangle trying to make her tap out, but Putri Pugney's not going to go quite into the night. Still surviving here, the Indonesian, with 80 seconds remaining.
Work to finish. She looks relaxed. She's not really trying to gas herself out at this point. She knows just how tough Pugney is. This is the third submission attempt that Pugney's been able to survive, and she looks to be okay.
Putri Pugney, 11-1 in karate. 5-0 Muay Thai, 5-0 amateur boxing. Still stuck in the triangle.
It's starting to get a little bit tight now. She's going back to the armbar.
Have a look at this. Is this the end now? Is this the finish? No, Putri Pugney survived.
Wow, how tough is Putri Pugney? A beautiful sweep there by Colbey Northcutt. End up on top, and she's going to have to choke. She's got an arm in guillotine, but the arm's on the wrong side. Pugney might be able to defend here.
One transition to submission to another from Colbey Northcutt in a thrilling debut so far. No transition karate ground belt, Putri Pugney to use the karate at the moment. Meanwhile, Colbey Northcutt 4-1 amateur mixed martial arts, 1-0 pro kickboxing. Jiu-jitsu purple belt, showing some of the jiu-jitsu on the ground here.
Looks like we're going to see a second round. You got to wonder how all these submission attempts are going to affect Northcutt into the second round, because Pugney's been able to survive a lot of dangerous positions.
Also, psychologically, how does it affect Colbey? A lot of people thought she would get Putri Pugney out.
let's take a look at how she got this to the ground. She set things up beautifully on the feet. Look at these long legs, throws the head kick, beautiful follow up with a straight right hand, and then Podmy just drives in as Colbey Northcutt jumps guard and gets nice and tight into submission after submission. Woo! Impressive first round.
And there she is, BUN, the Killer Bee, World Championship's own megastar here ringside in Singapore, amongst our many luminaries for the hottest ticketing talent tonight. It's one championship edge of greatness. Coming off that great bout against Sam Fairtex, Killer Bee Nguyen. Second round of three, total and utter domination by Colbey Northcutt in the opening 5 minutes, but Patri Pumit is here. She is defensive, she is resilient. Can she land some strikes here, Putney, on Colbey Northcutt? Colbey towers over it.
There are a lot of good submission attempts on that first round. I think Colbey Northcutt needs to change things up. I think she needs to do the work on the feet, deliver some of that powerful striking that she's known for. Because on the ground, I don't think she can finish Putney.
Good figure, Putney is open for a rear leg roundhouse kick. Off the right leg of Colbey Northcutt. Can she throw it? The Mawashi Getty.
I mean, he's keep those hands nice and tight to her face. You can see sniper. Colbey Northcutt trying to pick her shot.
Takes the right hand. Putney circling into the power side here of Northcutt. May not be why. Is she gassed a little here, the Indonesian? Throws the right hand, dances off to her left. An overwhelming 81% of fans on Rocket Fantasy, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game, tipping a win on debut from Colbey Northcutt tonight. And again, the evasion here from Putra Padmi.
Like that right hand in Northcutt, she's able to kind of set things up with the jab, but then boom, with the straight right hand. And there's another one of those big head kicks.
That's the Mawashi Getty I spoke about. The rear legs right roundhouse kick from Colbey Northcutt put to the damage here on Padmi. It's just the size, the reach of Colbey Northcutt, the extension in those arms. But look at Padmi, covers up against the high right ground kick, and still she rallies back to Indonesia. What heart! Can she go to the well? Can she dig down deep? Flurry forward and back up Colbey Northcutt. Right hand counter. Is Colbey Northcutt's confidence still riding as high as it was, say, 7 minutes ago, Mitch?
I think her confidence is even higher because she knows just how much control she has in this match. Everything she's throwing is landing. Her submissions are just micros inches away from finishing Podmy, but she just needs to find that one big shot, find that one big submission, because right now she's piecing Podmy up. But she also knows that Podmy is tough as nails, and there is no quitting this young lady.
Yoko getting signed kick banned from Northcutt. Putra Padmi could lead in with a left hook followed by a right uppercut. Trying to get on the inside in that proverbial phone booth with the towering Colbey Northcutt. There's a good gut muncher from Putra Padmi.
She needs to keep that head moving. She can't allow her head to stay in the same spot, especially when Northcutt throws the second shot. That second shot is right down the middle, and it's got a lot of heat behind it. The only thing that might be worried about with Northcutt is her gassing out, her throwing everything she has into at Podmy, and Podmy being able to take it and just wear this in the third round.
Looking as confident on the feet as she was in the ground game is Colbey Northcutt. Trying to sit behind the extension, behind the incredible reach of the American. 150 remains, second round of three. First round was all in one-way traffic, and that traffic was driving to Texas to Colbey Northcutt.
Padmi is an Indonesian Muay Thai champion. She is undefeated in Muay Thai, undefeated in amateur boxing, so she knows what she needs to be doing out there to capture the win. And I think at this point, she's just kind of riding the wave. She's surviving a lot of the early onslaught, and she's going to try to push this thing into deep water.
Needs to get a little bit more mustard behind these elbows, does Colbey Northcutt. She's throwing the kick, she's throwing the hands, they've landed, but they haven't affected Padmi with the power. Padmi get on the inside. It's been a glorified kickboxing contest here in the second round.
She's trying to set up that big right hand. She's stepping her kicks. She's trying to set up that big right hand, but Northcutt's very elusive.
Sliding out of the way of these things. Not there for the retaliation of Podney.
Colbey Northcutt on a one championship debut. Double jab right hand. She thought about it. Did Podney? Didn't have the distance in. Trying to edge away on the inside. Each the jab drops. The two punch combination from the American. Colbey comes forward again. Throws the hook in there for good measure.
Podney start throwing some big kicks. Listen how agile Northcutt is. Always on the ball, always moving. And the only thing Podney's doing is throwing those hands. I thought she's going to the body right there, but she needs to start doing some damage to the legs as well.
Colbey controlling the stand-up, although the elbows have not been powerful. There's a bit of a watch again from Colbey Northcutt. Good jab from Putra Patti. Overhand right from the Indonesian. End of the round, we're going to be jealous after two. Folks, don't forget to follow us across all your social media platforms. That One Championship on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. Sold out here in Singapore tonight as Colbey Northcutt needs some instructions from her husband and brother and the rest of her team.
You can see that immediately, soon as Northcutt sat down, she pointed to her right leg, and the corner immediately went to ice it. That needs to be a huge warning sign that goes off in the corner of Putri Podmi. They've got to start going after that lead leg, slow down the movement so they can land that big right hand. Northcutt's doing a good job of outpointing Putri Podmi in pretty much every single area, but Podmi is still dangerous. She's still got that big right hand. She's had knockouts in the past with that big right hand, so she's still dangerous in a lot of instances.
Third round of action. Second round was all stand-up. First round was pretty much all ground game. What do we see now? A lot of people thought we wouldn't see Putri Podmi in the third round, but she's still here. She's still game. It's a jab from her. Colbey Northcutt. Jab two, kangaroo from Northcutt. Another jab. Podmi trying to get on the inside. It's the round kick. Tries to bridge the gap. Forearms high. By Garry, Murashi Garry from Colbey Northcutt. Skip inside, fire kick from Podmi. Northcutt's chin up high in the air. She believes the height will prevent people from reaching her, but tell you what, yet again, maybe Podmi can get airborne with a left hook and an uppercut. Chest that chin up, Colbey Northcutt. Colbey smiles at him. As Mitch said, there was an injury to the right leg of Colbey Northcutt. They were icing it down between rounds. That's the back leg of the American. Maybe a target for Putra Podmi to go after. Certainly got to get on the inside. Get inside the range here of Northcutt. Jab down from Podmi, overhand right. That's more likely. Go for the headache maker. Happy to hear a curve on Northcutt. Kicking the elbow of Podmi in the second round. Throws that kick. Sticks it up for Otis Carr. Moves it hotly. Goes to a side kick. Pushes in the lead left. Podmi playing one game.
Podmi says, I can balance on one leg too. What you got?
I like the showmanship here from the Indonesian.
You see a little bit more aggression coming out of Northcutt. Right now she's okay to just stand at the end, keep Podmi at the back foot, and just kind of touch her up a little bit. That's a little bit more aggression coming from Podmi. That's what Podmi needs to do. She needs to make this dirty. Needs to get in close. Avoid the range game of Northcutt and start landing those big right hands.
Colbey Northcutt really playing a point scoring karate game at the moment. These blows aren't going to knock down Putra Podmi. This isn't karate point scoring. That's more like it. A little bit more gusto behind that round kick from Colbey Northcutt.
Man, the chin on Podmi. She's just taking these shots, coming forward, pawing out there with her left hand, trying to set up the big right hand. But just the distance and range of Northcutt is just something truly spectacular. I mean, she's been in here hundreds of times, ladies and gentlemen. A 36 times martial arts world champion. So you know just how good she is on the feet and how she understands her own distance.
Hundreds of times mixed under those karate point-scoring rules, but only a handful of times in mixed martial arts. And the more that Northcutt will go through the ranks here from the championship, she's going to have to start to really load up power on these strikes.
She's also a Texas State Golden Gloves boxing champion, so she knows how to put power into those hands, but she's playing it kind of safe at this point. She's doing just enough to keep Podney right where she is and touch her up, and that's what this is pretty much boiling down to. Not seeing a lot of big risks taken by Northcutt. We're not seeing any sort of big fancy knockout kicks that she's trying to throw.
It's a matter of reach being the difference here. 11 centimeters tall, as I said, the wingspan of an albatross on Colbey Northcutt. And Putney's had trouble all night getting on the inside. A couple of times she's gotten there, a couple of times she's put the leather on the face of Colbey Northcutt, like with that jab. There she goes for the uppercut. She needs to come in and go for a full-on flurry. Put the pedal down. Throw caution to the wind. Pull out all the stops here. Putri Putney to have a chance to turn the tide. Because at the moment, the reach, and there's another solid 1-2 from Northcutt, is just dominating Putney.
I think this is going to do a lot of good, sort of work for Putri Putney's stock. I think, getting out there, doing work with a, 36-time martial arts world champion is only going to boost her own learning in this game. And that's kind of what's happening right here. She's going to learn from these mistakes, but also, Northcutt is going to go back in and say, I want to be a finisher. I just don't want to go out there and outpoint people. I want to end people's night, and I need to make these necessary adjustments to make that happen.
Sitting behind the jab and the lead hook, Colbey Northcutt, 30 seconds to go now. Speaks off, getting the clockwise, I should say. Another jab there from Northcutt. Good defense against the man, getting front kick. Jab from Putney. Has she got a couple of big salvos left just for the artillery, the Indonesian? Jab, flicking jab to the jaw there from Northcutt. Good defense. Putney tries to get on the inside now with a flurry. Quarter angle turn, little pirouette though from the Texan. Overhand right from Putney. Final seconds. We go to the judges. It'll comfortably go the way of Colbey Northcutt. It was all striking second and third round from Colbey Mitch.
Yeah, this was basically a kickboxing clinic put on by one Colbey Northcutt. Just finding her range and keeping Putney at that range, covering distance exceptionally well. When she wanted to throw, she threw. When she wanted to do damage, she would do it. But just excellent footwork. Look at that. Taking almost zero damage, not really putting herself at any big risk, but ultimately a tremendous performance from Colbey Northcutt. I'm looking to see what this young lady can do inside one Super Series and also one championship.
Okay, let's go to Tom Lau and make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Colbey.
Tonon closes the distance. Now, Shinya is a judo black belt, but Tonon is a high-level American wrestler, so he immediately flies in, scissors the legs, and now is in the guard. Shinya transitions into a single leg and jumps on the top position. The intricacies of grappling are so diverse. Everything is step by step.
I know a lot of our fans will be looking at the possibility of punches here and there, but it's not going to happen, not in this one. But the difference between what Tonon has done all of his career, Mitch, here, is that he's got to deal with the cage. The cage wall is going to be a big factor, and it's something that Shinya's very used to, of course.
Yeah, me and Rich Franklin were just talking about the cage. How do you see this impacting this contest?
Yeah, that's something that Gary's obviously not used to. I'll just say this. From the beginning of this, watching the pat-down outside of the ring, it was interesting because normally you're checking the gloves and all those kinds of things, which is another advantage that Shinya would be used to, being able to grab hold of the not loop into the glove and whatnot, but little advantages like this with the cage and whatnot, it can become a big factor in this grappling match.
Both men got a great reception from the crowd here at the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Shinya Aoki, a big favorite here, has been for some time, but it's a great pleasure for them to see Garry Tonon make an appearance.
Shinya Aoki looks very slim. He looks very slender, but he is shockingly strong. You can see Tonon's got his butterfly hooks in where he has the feet kind of on the insides of the legs there of Tonon. Now he's starting to push away and create space, but Aoki is staying so close and tight. Let's take a look at that scissor takedown that Tonon attempted in the beginning of the match.
It was a fast start from him, that's for sure. Oh, now.
Watch out, watch out, watch out.
Maybe we'll take a look at that takedown attempt a little bit later in the fight. You can see Tonon's kind of going inverted now. He's got the legs triangled around it.
It's going to be like a couple of king cobras, isn't it? Slowly just tightening with every move, every inch to the left or to the right, tightening and advancing the position.
You can see there was an attempt at a north-south position, but Garry is constantly moving, Rich.
Yeah, this is exactly what I was expecting. You can see that Garry, you're popping up for that reverse triangle there, flowing for something, and this is very typical of Shinya's style. Very constrictor-like, taking inch by inch what he can and just moving little by little, and you have to look at the little nuances of what he's doing here, flattening out the knees, looking to come across and pass here. Obviously, Tonon's pushing down on the head to try to keep him from coming to the side mount or something like that, and then
gets the headlock as Shinya gets to his feet. But again, Tonon pushed up against the cage, something he's not used to having to deal with.
Oh, Steve, did you just see that? What he did, Aoki had his hands clasped together, but Tonon actually used his feet to separate the hands of Aoki.
Yeah, that was a very slick way to break the grip there.
The wrestling of Shinya Aoki, this is definitely his style. He likes this boa constrictor type tactic where every time his opponent almost exhales, he's advancing the position. Aoki jumps onto the back of Tonon.
And the crowd are loving it as well, and they see the possibility of the arm around the throat.
Yeah, but Shinya finally got the bottom hook in, and now he's got body triangle there, and that's a good controlling position.
He's got the body triangle, and he's got the leg wrapped around. So you can see his right leg there trying to hook the other side of Tonon's leg.
I'll say this, though. In a grappling match, it's quite difficult when you take the back to finish with a rear naked choke, because in MMA, I'm used to just being able to punch somebody in the head to
right.
set up my choke.
Right.
There is no punch to the head set up here.
Aoki's got long limbs. He's got long fingers as well, hasn't he? Which, of course, is so intricate in these tight, tight moves. Just to get the leverage that you need and tremendous flexibility as well.
They're more like tentacles, Steve. They basically just latch out, grasp, hold, and they never quite let you go. They're always like sucked on and controlling into position. I spent way too much time with him on the mat and just,
well,
look at this. I mean, check out this body triangle. This is so impressive because of the fact that Tonon is known as such a scrambler. Look at the way Aoki takes the back. He's there. He immediately flies. He's known for flying submissions, but he's not known for flying position attempts. And he just jumps into the position, figure fours his legs, and that's where we are right now.
I'll tell you, that replay right there is a good example that we always talk about Shinya being the kind of grappler who is like a boa constrictor who just takes advantage of every little inch that you give him and slowly progresses his game. But that was a movement right there where we expected Garry Tonon to do things like that, to explode and flow, and Shinya exploded and flowed right with him.
And listen to the crowd as they get back up to their feet. They are just looking at this with intense concentration here at the Singapore Indoor Stadium. And a reminder that only a submission can win this. So we're inside the final 10 minutes of the contest. A 15-minute fight.
The judges are completely out of this. They might as well go get some chicken rice because we got time here. We got 9 minutes, but the first 6 minutes just flew by. Tonon's now got Aoki pressed up against the cage, which is no small feat because Aoki is tremendously strong.
No, and I think that's the first time we've seen that in this match.
Now both of them, look at that. Attempts for the scissor leg, but a good sprawl from Aoki. Look at this. Check out Tonon. To escape the body triangle of Shinya Aoki is a whole different world as far as grappling is concerned. To get out of that body triangle and to scramble like that, that's impressive. Now we're into the seated position here. Aoki's laced that arm. Now they're going right into the clinch.
So Aoki with the hands clasped behind the back. Tonon with the more open stance. What's that left hand doing of Tonon?
Those are some long arms from Shinya. To be able to bend over like that and to still clasp your hands around like that.
When your opponent's waist is out that far. These two right here, they're in an over-under. You can see the Tonon's trying to swim in with that hand. Nice takedown there. It's a very difficult thing to do because what you were saying about Shinya's arms being so extended that it's difficult to earn that takedown, because typically control there, you have to pull the hips in, like suck the hips into the body, which he didn't end up doing and still earned the takedown.
He's still clasping behind that back there. Oh, he's just let go, as I say.
Again, Shinya's attempting to go. Now he's giving up his leg. This is what Tonon's known for. He's got some of the most devastating leg locks in all of the game. Aoki does the right thing by triangling those legs.
The best leg lock specialist we've seen in ONE Championships mixed martial arts is Imanari. And
Tonon attempted there. You can see the small little adjustment to take the figure four that Shinya had. He pulled that away. Now he's going after the heels there.
He submitted. He tapped out the man who beat Masakatsu Imanari by a leg lock. Has done the same thing to Shinya Aoki. Garry Tonon has introduced himself to a mixed martial arts audience here in Singapore and said, how do you like my grappling against one of your former kings?
Did you see how fast he threw on that heel hook?
It was over in a moment, wasn't it?
Shinya was in control the first half of that match, but just a slight mistake. How Tonon extended the leg, locked it, released the figure four from Shinya, and applied the heel hook was a thing of beauty. Here's Shinya rolling in, and this was the beginning of the end. Once Tonon gets a hold of that leg, that's all she wrote. Here it is, double cross the legs and just attack the heel, and Shinya knew that was it.
Yeah, there's no point going too far if you know exactly what's going on. And I think Shinya knew that the writing was on the wall there. Garry Tonon wins by submission. The only way anyone was going to win this one. Shinya Aoki, what a great experience. What a great sport to have accepted this battle against the surely premier grappler in the world. Dom Lau with the official call.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee Olivier Coast has put a stop to this fight after 7 minutes and 47 seconds for your winner by way of heel hook submission, Garry Tonon!
Listen to
gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coast, put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 31 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of guillotine choke, Aung La N Sang!
They come together. And already it's brutal. But Sapp is down on his back. And this is one of the conceivable ways that it could end, because Gracie is an excellent submission fighter. This fight is brought to you by Jaco. And it may not be a long one, Jason.
You know, Hollis did exactly what Hollis needed to do, get the fight to the ground as quickly and efficiently as possible. I'm actually kind of surprised that Bob Sapp was able to work a little bit of guard and survive an ankle lock attempt. So this could be a little longer fight than we anticipate.
Well, he's tried his hand at a number of different fighting styles, Bob Sapp. This is his latest modus operandi. Used to be an American footballer with the Minnesota Vikings.
Bob Sapp has done everything. He's a movie star, he's a product endorser, you know, former K-1 kickboxer and MMA fighter. Bob takes a lot of flack. People think that, you know, he's not really an MMA fighter, and he wants to prove that this is Bob Sapp 2.0.
Oh, there's a big punch that Gracie just landed. He tried for a second. The first one really got through, and the last couple have as well. And Bob Sapp could be in trouble, and it is over. They were heavy punches. I could see them very clearly here. Bob Sapp was on his back, and he took two or three heavy, heavy blows from Olles Gracie. Bob Sapp's up, and he's, yeah, that's the way it is in MMA. Great sportsmanship from Bob Sapp, but he took some big, big blows to the head. And make no mistake, Olles Gracie is a huge man in his own right. And he's got great athleticism. He really let Bob Sapp have it there on the ground. And you know, when the blows are coming in as heavy as those were, they cannot last for long. You can't let a fight like that go on for much longer, because it's serious stuff, it's dangerous stuff. And great respect to our referee for jumping in time. Let's take another look. It went to the mat quickly, as we expected it would. But then our expectations were that Gracie would get a submission. But it's these blows that you're seeing with the right hand that did the damage. And you could see the pain on Bob's face there. He took one at the top of the head, on the back of the head, which is often dangerous and can dull your senses. We said it would be quick, folks. And it certainly was. Some speculation as to whether Bob Sapp actually tapped out there and called the fight before the referee got a chance. Let's hear the official word in a few moments.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by way of tap out due to strikes after 1 minute, 18 seconds of round one.
Kondo in southpaw stance. Gracie at 51 years old, looking in great condition. A little cutting side kick to the lead thigh there from Gracie. Plenty of instruction early on from the corner of Yuki Kondo. The tension here inside this massive arena, you could cut it with a knife. And I'm sure watching live in 138 countries around the world, the intrigue since this one was announced, the comeback of Renzo Gracie.
You can see Kondo immediately start to go to that leg kick. Because in Renzo Gracie's last match against Matt Hughes, Matt Hughes used the leg kicks very effectively, but he wasn't in the southpaw stance. He was coming out right-handed. Oh, Renzo gets into the clinch. This is where he wants it.
Got munching knee there from Renzo. Backs off Yuki Konda. That last match of Renzo against Matt Hughes back in April 10, 2010. Konda looking for the inside leg.
Hondo's throwing out that right jab, but he's not really, he's just kind of using it as a range finder. It's very short, he's not extending it, he's not stepping into it, he's just kind of pawing it out there.
A real filling up process here in the opening round for both of these veterans, both of these legends. Multiple King of Pancrase, Yuki Konda. His last contest on Christmas Eve of last year. Was a TKO, I should say, a loss to Chutara Nakao.
It's been 11 years since Renzo's been in a mixed martial arts competition, but he did compete last year in Finland at the ADCC Grappling Championship, so he has some competitive experience still. Oh, nice right hand as he tries to close in for the takedown.
And that's what Renzo needs to do against the southpaw. Go the right hand down the center corridor.
He's got to throw that right hand, work to the clinch. Try to get Konda to the mat.
A legends matchup. Left roundhouse kick there from Yuki Konda. Probing with the rangefinder is Renzo Gracie. The Gracie name synonymous with the sport. Renzo Gracie, one of the most beloved martial artists in the world. I've never heard anyone say a bad word about Renzo Gracie.
Like to see Renzo throw that right hand when Konda throws that, those leg kicks. There's not a lot on those leg kicks. Renzo could step in and connect with a big right hand.
Referee Olivia Coles just telling both men to pick up the war crane. You've got to wonder what's going through Renzo's mind. What's he feeling right now? Returning to the cage in front of a massive audience for the first time in 7 years. Left roundhouse kick, looking for the ribs there, was Konda.
See the determination on his face, he's trying to find that distance. Kondo's the one putting out these shots, finding that leg, touching the leg with his own. But he hasn't really done any damage, nothing significant has landed on either end.
1 minute 30 remaining, first round, it's been a tipping of the toes in the proverbial waters for both men. Feeling it out, seeing what each other has to offer, trying to find it. Shink in the arm. Sharp goes up for Renzo Gracie, thrust out the jab as the Brazilian.
See, as he's throwing that leg kick, he's open to a lot because he's not really stepping in. His head's still in the center line. Renzo could step in, either catch that inside leg kick and charge in for a double leg, or just throw that straight right hand right down the middle.
Emotionally fully invested, whether you're a pancreas fan of Yuki Kondo, or whether, as everyone is, you're a fan of Renzo Gracie.
Potentially 1.7 billion people on the absolute edge of their seats. One of the slower rounds we've had here tonight, but it's still, these guys have so much experience.
Tell me your heart isn't racing. Tell me your heart isn't fluttering every beat quicker when Kondo throws something close to connecting at Renzo Gracie.
But he's not really putting his power behind his shots. They're just light touches, you know? I'm really waiting for Renzo to shoot him for a takedown because Kondo has got Renzo doing nothing, and he could throw some serious heat at Renzo right now.
Second round, Kondo goes back to the inside leg. And Gracie finds an opportunity to take Yuki Kondo down. They are barking instructions in the corner of Yuki Kondo, screaming at him like Gordon Ramsay.
That's what Kondo needs to do, back him up and throw some big shots. Put some combinations together. Throw the straight right, big right, big straight left, big right hook.
Renzo's talking to Yuki Kondo, he's trying to bait him in here. And again, Renzo having words, calling Yuki forward. Throws a right hand against the southpaw. And Kondo probing with the jab. Kondo's chin a little high now. Renzo saw the opening, quick with the right hand again.
Let's see him double up on that shot.
Mr. Olivier Coste has put a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 40 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, Renzo Gracie.